Welcome back to Sure Voice. My name is Adda Sure, and I'm so happy you're joining me today on this channel. And we're going to discuss the effect, we're going to continue to discuss the effect of the head voice on the entire voice. And today I want to talk about the effect of mantra chanting or mantra singing on our voice, on those of us who are professional singers or who are on the path to being such. So not only does chanting of mantras or chanting of prayer, of any kind of prayer, help our state of mind, it helps our spirit, and it has wonderful healing powers on our voice. So this is going to be a brief video discussing the experiences that I've had over the years of including mantra chanting into my personal singing habits and how that's affected my breathing and my ability to enter that head voice, which allows for an integration of all the aspects, all the levels of all the range in the voice. Now, when we are, of course, when we are using our voice for prayer, for singing of prayers, whether it's, you know, whatever faith you're from, it helps us balance ourselves. It helps us have a clearer mind, especially in times of tremendous world conflict and tremendous suffering that we're witnessing, whether we've experienced it ourselves or we're witnessing it and we're hearing about it. It's very easy to get lost in all that, the news, and to kind of lose our own sense of spiritual compass. So the scriptures and the great scriptures and the great prayers from all the great faiths are wonderful things to take hold of. Now, when you are chanting sacred syllables, they are pure frequencies that help you align the etheric and the chakras, if you will, if you're into that terminology. But more importantly, they are balancing and rebalancing your breathing. I've talked about that before, that the exhalation, a longer exhalation, will first of all prepare you for then a more smooth inhalation that's in proportion to what the body feels it needs after that particular exhalation. So for example, if we just chant Om, which so many of you are familiar with, just the primordial sound Om on one note, and you hold it for four beats. And then you re-chant that. That can be very, very healing. I'm going to pause for a moment because I want to put my tambura accompaniment CD for you to get the full effect, especially if you use a tambura CD. Just one moment. All right, we have that tambura on. Now, tambura is a ancient Indian instrument. It's a round instrument like this, and it has five strings. They're basically almost the same note. And when they're played very, very skillfully, as you hear in the background, you'll hear harmonies emerging from that particular use of those five strings and its tuning. So that's why you can hear. This tambura is tuned to D. Om. Om. You could also sing this. Heidi. Right? Guys, oh. that was interesting. So as I continue to work with that, as you notice, my voice got smoother. And the little phlegm that came in here, because this is the first notes of the day, cleared up. So if you can look online for a tape of a tambura, and you can use that as a way to center yourself singing an om. You don't have to sing an om. You could take a sacred text from your religion and take one word of it and do it over and over again, or several. I'm going to pause for a moment so I can turn off the tambura. So for me, I found that chanting, repetitive mantra chanting, was extremely interesting for developing a very, very, very subtle breath control that I had never had before. And I found that in the beginning, when I was doing the sacred chanting, under the direction of an enlightened master who is not a self-proclaimed master, but a truly, you know, initiated and an enlightened being from the ancient Hindu traditions. In any case, as I was doing those mantras, I found myself finding it very hard to do, and which surprised me, being a trained singer. So when we deal with the spiritual aspects of singing, then obviously if we're singing spiritually charged music, then that will develop our connection now to that aspect of singing. So now remember to like and subscribe if you like this channel, and if you like this subject and you want more of it, I'd be happy to do a whole series on it. And if you want to hear me singing sacred music, of course you can go to my healing mantra 1, 2, or 3 that I created a little very simplistic video with photography I took, because I used to love to do photography and I still do, with improvisations on sacred chant. It's a CD I created with my brother Ital, sure, many years ago. It was improvisations. We simply sat in the studio and we let the inspiration flow and certain chants that we knew together. And it's from Jewish and Hindu faiths. So we improvised, and each one that we improvised with, we recorded. And then we took the ones we liked. It's not like we preset anything. And it was a lot of fun, and the spirit was with us. And our combined study and application of these traditions allowed us to collaborate. And that sort of magical and mystical musical collaboration is very rare. And I was very, very fortunate to have that and still have that with my wonderful brother, Ital. So I hope that you've enjoyed this small exploration of spiritual chanting on our development as singers and how that can help us balance our breathing, as well as balance our mind and our spirit, give us greater clarity and greater energy, so that we're using our skill as a singer to also get ourselves closer to the divine within and without. So being a singer can really bring you untold treasures, much more than what the world may offer you. And with that blessing, I wish you a wonderful week. Again, if you like the video, please like, subscribe, comment below, and I look forward to seeing you again very, very soon. Have fun singing, and sing to the Lord a new song.